This video is provided as supplementary material for courses taught at Howard Community College. And in this video, I just want to do a few more examples of word problems involving percent. So here's the first problem. An online store sells a sweater for $32.50. It also adds on a 6% sales tax and $3.25 for shipping. What is the total cost for buying the sweater? Okay, so we've got two steps to do. First, we want to find out how much the sales tax was. And then we want to add that amount and the $3.25 for shipping to the original cost of the sweater, $32.50. Okay, so let's find out what the sales tax is. We're looking for the sales tax. That's going to be our x. And we're going to make that the numerator of a fraction. The denominator will be the cost of the sweater. And we'll set that equal to 6%, written as a fraction, or 6 over 100. So now I've got this proportion. I want to solve it. I want to get rid of the 32.50 that's in the denominator of the left side. I want to get the x by itself. So I'll multiply both sides by that amount. That allows me to cancel out 32.50 on the left and just get an x. On the right, I've got to multiply 6 times 32.50. That's going to be 195. I've got to divide that by 100. So to divide that by 100, I'll just take the decimal point at the end of it, move it two places to the left, and the denominator, the 100, just becomes a 1. So x equals 1.95, or $1.95. That's the sales tax. Now I've got to add the cost of the sweater, $32.50, plus the sales tax, $1.95, plus the shipping cost, $3.25, and find out what the final cost is going to be. So 5 plus 5 is 10. I'll write the 0 and carry a 1. I'm going to add that 1 to the 9 that's over here to make 10. 5 more is 15, and 2 more is 17. So I'll write the 7, add a 1 that I'm carrying. 1 plus 2 is 3, plus 1 more is 4, plus 3 more is 7. I've got 3 in the next column. I'll bring that down. And the total cost for the sweater, the sweater plus the sales tax plus the shipping, is going to be $37.70. Okay, let's look at one more. 10 years ago, the population of a town was 1,250. Now its population is 1,525. What percent has the population increased in the last 10 years? Okay, we've got to do two steps here. First, we've got to find out how many more people there are now than there were 10 years ago. And then we want to find out what percent that is of the number of people there were 10 years ago. So let's find out how many more people we have. That would be the current population, 1,525, minus the population 10 years ago. When we subtract this, we find out that the population has increased by 275. So we can write 275, that's the amount it increased by, over 1,250, that's the amount it was, and set that fraction or ratio equal to what we're looking for, which is the percent. That's x percent. Now I'm going to write x percent as a fraction, which means it's just going to be x over 100. Okay, so let's write that x over 100. Let me clean that up. So now I've got a proportion, 275 over 1,250 equals x over 100. We want to find x. That's going to be the percent that the population increased by. So to find out what x is, I'll multiply both sides of the equation by 100. That allows me to get x all by itself on the right side. Then I have to multiply 100 times 275. That just means adding two zeros to the 275. And I'm going to divide that by 1,250. When I do the division, I find out that x is equal to 22. So that means the population increased by 22% from 10 years ago to the present. Okay, so I hope that helps. Take care. I'll see you next time.